Welcome to Sandals Royal Bahamian.
Sandals is one of our favorite all-inclusive resorts in the Caribbean. And one thing we really like about it is that every Sandals have multiple gourmet restaurants that offer really good quality food. We stayed there for 7 nights, so we had a chance to try every dining option available. In this video, I will show you our experience in every one of them. So if you are only here for a few nights, you can watch this video and decide which one you will go to.
Hi, this is Ken and welcome to my channel, Ken Travels 360.
Good evening, this is the first day in Sandals Royal Bahamian and it's now time for the first dinner. Tonight, we have booked the restaurant La Plume. It's a French restaurant. La Plume restaurant is the French restaurant on site. It offers exquisite French cuisine. They serve breakfast and dinner here. For dinner, reservation is required. So we've just arrived outside La Plume restaurant. Let's go in. So we have just been seated in La Plume restaurant. We ordered some champagne as the starting beverage. Cheers. Bonsoir, so the first course has arrived, the entree in French term. I have ordered, well, amazingly, it's escargot again. Yes, I have ordered escargot every night during the cruise, and well, I'm not gonna pass over escargot when it's available. So that's my starter.
And I have got French onion soup.
Right, I'm gonna try the escargot. Wow, this is really good. Actually, I have to say this is better than the escargot I have every day on Royal Caribbean. This is divine. So in front of me, this main course is the beef medallion, cooked medium rare with some asparagus. It's beautifully laid out. Then we have the lamb shank, also very prettily laid out. And finally, we have the Kanoo l'orange, the orange duck, cooked very nicely and beautifully arranged again as well. So we'll try it and see how they taste like. Right, this is the aftermath. Right, all the paste have been taken away, so I'm gonna comment on how the main course went, how the main courses went. We have three main courses. The lamb shank, I think, was probably my favorite. It was really tender, the lamb, and it was really succulent. It's amazing. Then we have the beef medallions. They were cooked really nicely, and I enjoyed that as well. And then there is the Kanoo l'orange. We have found it on the Royal Caribbean cruise that how difficult it is to cook that perfectly. And this one was an example how it should be done. It was really, really nice, and I approve of it.
It's definitely true to say, here, they take things to another level. It really is quite astonishing. Absolutely amazing.
Right, the first part of the dessert has arrived. Yes, you heard that right, the first part. We have ordered two desserts each. The first one is a chocolate cake. Ah, the second part has arrived as well. We've ordered also a creme brulee and a peach tart as well. But we're gonna try the cake first and the other two. So this is the view from La Plume. If you get to sit by the window, there's a very nice view of the East Bay. Thank you. It was a great, wonderful experience tonight. So how would I rate it? Overall, I rate the whole dinner experience 9.7 out of 10. The food was absolutely exquisite. The escargot were excellent with a rich flavor. And the three main courses, they were all cooked to a very high standard. And the desserts were also really good, particularly the chocolate cake. The only reason I didn't give it a higher mark is because we still have a few other restaurants to go. For breakfast, they overcook to all the dishes here, including eggs benedict, smoked salmon benedict, steak and eggs any style, to name a few classic.
So we just had the breakfast at La Plume. So yeah, they have steak and eggs, but the steak is a little bit chewy. And apart from that, everything else we could get at buffet. It's a nice experience to try it, or at least once perhaps, just to experience it. But we might not come back here again. We probably would do a buffet in Kanoo instead.
So tonight is day two evening, and we've got an exciting restaurant book. It's the Butch's. They have a reputation of doing great steak there. So hopefully it's the same as other Sandals. So I'm outside Butch's Island Chop House now. You will find Butch's in many Sandals resorts. It's named after the late Gordon Butch Stewart, who was the founder and owners of Sandals Resorts. This place usually serves the best steak and seafood in each Sandals. So we have just a look at the menu at the Butcher's, and we have decided what we are going to have. Right, Steve's starter has arrived. It's a pork belly. Looks really nice. This is the grilled shrimp that I ordered. Also looks really nice. It's not very big, but we've ordered many main courses, so this will do. Yes, please. So Steve has ordered the steak Diane. It's cooked medium rare, and come with béarnaise sauce. And he ordered a side order of Parmesan truffle fries as well. So hopefully that will be good. As for me, I have ordered the surf and turf. There's a lobster tail as well as a filet mignon, also cooked medium rare. And I also have got the béarnaise sauce. We also order some lamb chops. So we just finished the main courses. The surf and turf was really good. The filet mignon in it is just exquisite. It's really tender and really juicy. The lobster tail is good, but probably not as good as I would have expected. Steve has the Angus steak, and I tried a little bit as well. It was quite good. Probably could have been better. Finally, we've also got the lamb chops. The lamb chops, I don't know if it's because we ate it after we have finished our first main course. It was a little bit chewy. It's still very tasty, but yes, slightly chewy. Right, the dessert has arrived. It's a chocolate sim pie. It has got a chocolate cake as well as some ice cream. So I have almost finished this chocolate sim pie now. It's really, really good. It's very chocolatey, and the cake is just really amazing. Okay, so here's the final verdict of this meal. I think the starter was not really as good as it should have been. My garlic shrimp was a little bit cold, and I think Steve's pork belly wasn't that special either. For the main course, the steak were really good. This is what they are good for, so that's great. The lobster tail was not as good as I thought it should have been, and the lamb chops was slightly chewy. At the end, the desserts were really good though. The chocolate sim pie was probably the best dessert that we have had this trip. So overall, I will give it a score of 91 out of 100. Yes, it's a lower score than yesterday La Plume, but yeah, it's overall still a good experience, but definitely yesterday's meal was better.
If you enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel with notifications enabled. That way, you won't miss another video from me.
Tonight is white night. This is the best I could come up with. So we're now going to Soy for dinner. It's probably one of my favorite places because they have good sushi. However, even though most Sandals have a Soy, they have very different standard. The one at Sandals Grand St. Lucian has really, really good sushi. The one at Sandals Grand Antigua, it was okay, but not really memorable. And the one at Sandals Montego Bay last year, it's a great resort, but the soy there is not so good. They didn't have a salmon for the whole week. I can't imagine how you can do that for a sushi restaurant. But we'll find out how this one fares.
All of this cocktail, don't really know what it is. All I know is it's got sake, vodka, and some fruit. That's quite nice.
Chicken karaage. And this is the shrimp tempura. So the sushi has arrived. It's arranged beautifully.
So yes, just had all the sushi and all the tempura and sashimi. Everything is good, but it's probably not as good as the ones I had before in Sandals Grand St. Lucia. It was perfect there. It's almost like sushi from Japan. Here is good, but yeah, not the best ever. I would rate it about 88 out of 100, so still a very respectable score, but not something that is like out of this world.
So this is half an hour before departure, but we just have enough time to get back to Seoul. The food today is really, really good. I really enjoy all the sushi today. Probably the best soy experience I have for this trip. I probably have to upgrade my rating of them. It's really good.
Today we're here at Kimonos for Tapanyaki.
Welcome to Sandals Bahamas. My name is Chef Joe at your service for tonight. Are you ready to rock and roll?
Ready. Yeah.
That's for you. Hey!
So this is the duck salad.
So we just finished the dinner at Kimonos, and we enjoyed the dinner. It was definitely quite spectacular as a show, and the food is all right. It's not really that spectacular. For me, teppanyaki like this is always more about the spectacle than the food. Overall, I would rate it about 75 out of 100. If you are staying here long enough, then I will certainly try this at least once. But if you are here for only like 3-4 nights, then perhaps you want to make sure you try La Plume or Butcher's first before you try Kimonos. Behind me is the Tesoro restaurant. It's the Italian restaurant on site. For mornings, it's also the place where you can get buffet breakfast.
So let's take a look at what they have for breakfast. There's all this pastry and bread. There's yogurt. They've got fruits. They've got all the cold cuts, cheese,
and smoked salmon.
The hot foods are the usual stuff, tomatoes, French toast. They do have an egg station. They can cook an omelette to order, as well as fried eggs, poached eggs, etc.
At lunchtime, it offers pizza.
So now we're in the Italian restaurant, Tesoro.
The starter in Tesoro is a seafood salad buffet. They've got focaccia, pesto, minestrone soup, and lots of different cold cuts. Then they have lots of seafood, artichokes, and zucchini, etc. A very impressive array of salad ingredients. For the main course, I've got the seafood linguine, whereas Steve's got the lamb shank.
As for dessert, in the name of research, we order all three desserts to try. They are respectively the peach tart, tiramisu, and gelato.
Overall, this is better than I expected. Very often, we found the American version of Italian food a bit too sweet, particularly the tomato-based ones. But today, we found the food quite okay overall, and I'll rate it 80 out of 100.
So this is the Kanoo restaurant. It's open for breakfast and lunch normally. For breakfast, it serves buffet breakfast, and lunchtime, they serve pan-Caribbean dishes, such as Bahamian cracked chicken, escovitch grouper fillet. So for lunch, we ordered two dishes. One is beef teriyaki, and I've got the Bahamian cracked chicken.
After the rather mediocre lunch, we got some desserts. That looks quite amazing. Hopefully it'll be much better than the main course. Steve has got the apple and cinnamon cake, and I've got a chocolate cheesecake. It does look really good.
So right now it's 5:30. We're having a drink here first, and then we are gonna go to Kanoo's, where they're doing the returnees dinner tonight. So the sun has set on the West Bay side, and there's a beautiful dusk view behind. So tonight is the Sandals returnees dinner at Kanoo's.
So we would love to officially welcome you in this special occasion, this special dinner, on behalf of the entire team and the management team. We also thank you for choosing Royal Sandals Bahamian for spending your vacation, and the entire team wishing you the beautiful rest of your stay. All right, we wish you a beautiful vacation. Thank you, and we're all grateful you're spending your time here.
So this is the menu for the returnees dinner. The soup, I'm not quite sure about it. And salad is quite funny, star anise. The main course is good, strip loin steak and lobster tail. So the next course is a salad, which is the star anise and scotch bonnet infused watermelon. It's a very weird salad, but actually it tastes quite all right. So the main course is right. This is a pink roasted beef strip loin with broiled Caribbean lobster tail. So basically serve and turn, but I've got an extra lobster tail as well. So the dessert has arrived. It's a Jamaican rum cheesecake. So we just had the returnees dinner here at Kanoo's. So I think overall I'll rate it about 82 out of 100. It's quite good, but I think what we had yesterday, as well as the day before in La Plume, as well as Butch's, were probably much better. But overall, still a good effort.
So this is the last morning at Sandals Royal Bahamian. We're here at Kanoo for breakfast. Let's look at the food offering. Scrambled egg, crispy bacon, breakfast sausage, potato wedges. This one is quite interesting. Asparagus mushroom with parmesan, and smoked salmon benedict. Loads of fruits and yogurt. Lots of pastries.
Overall, I think the breakfast at Kanoo is probably the best out of the three choices.
in Sandals Royal Bahamian.
Over here, you have the Queen's Pearls Public House. It's an English pub.
Every Sandals has one English pub, and this one is the English pub offering the traditional English grub. You can get those traditional fish and chips, chicken wings, cottage pie, burgers, bang and mash, as you would expect from an English pub. As you can see, I've ordered their signature dish, which is the fish and chips. So I just finished the fish and chips, and it's a really good quality. And I will rate it a solid 75 out of 100.
These are all the restaurants that offer dinner when I stayed there. Normally, there is a Gordon's on the Pier restaurant, which offers panoramic ocean views from a seaside setting. And they serve great seafood there, apparently. I was really looking forward to try that, but unfortunately, the pier was severely damaged by a hurricane a few weeks earlier, and as a result, that restaurant was not available for us. So, I've covered all the dinner venues. There are some restaurants that are only open for lunch, and I won't go into detail here. There is Aralia House on the private island, which serves really good jerk chicken. I've covered them in another video about the private island, which you can watch by clicking the link above. There is also Calico Cafe. They serve mostly beachside grill stuff like burgers and hot dogs. And finally, there are a couple of food trucks. One is Coco Queen, and they serve local specials, conch fritters and fish tacos. And the other is Sweet and Things, which serves cakes, coffees and crepes. Lunch at Sandals is generally a very casual affair. It's really just more functional to feed you. The main dining event is always the dinner. Okay, it's time to select my top 3 restaurants. Number 1 for me is definitely Le Plume, with their escargot, lamb shanks, steaks, and carne à l'orange. It's simply the best restaurant at Sandals Royal Bahamian. Number 2, and it's a close choice, but I think it's Butch's Chops House. It's usually the most sought-after venue for reservation at other Sandals, but I think here, Le Plume just edge it. Number 3 for me is Soy. They offer really great sushi, and for me, it's such a joy to be able to go on a sushi feast, so I've got to put it in the top 3. So there you go, my top 3 restaurants at Sandals Royal Bahamian. Thank you for watching this video. Why don't you check out some other videos I've made about my stay at Sandals? See you over there.